Hey guys, it's Jen, and you are joining me in my laundry room because the sun has set and it's really overcast outside, and this is the best lighting that I'm gonna get. And I wanted to do a really quick update because we haven't made a video in forever, and I have a little bit of time while Naomi is sleeping. I've got the baby monitor like just a few feet behind me, listening out for her, so this might get cut short. But anyways, for those of you who don't know, didn't watch our labor and delivery story, I did have a C-section, and I won't get into like the whole reasoning and all that good stuff, but basically it's because I got an infection and I was not close enough to delivery to kind of just deliver the baby and be done with it. So the infection is called chorio for short, or chorioamnionitis. You can Google it if you want more information. But I got a fever. I started getting symptomatic in labor. I started getting chills. I'm normally a really hot person and I never want the blankets. I always want it like frigidly cold. But I kept having them like up the heat, and I was like, go get me some warm blankets from the OR. Like, I'm really cold. So I started being symptomatic. So that, I had like a hundred point something, I don't remember what it was, 100.7 or more. Anyway, so they started me on antibiotics, and because I had the fever, then the baby was going to need antibiotics after birth as well. And so the reason why we had to go for the C-section is because she started to show symptoms that she was sick, and like I said, I was nowhere near being able to deliver the baby vaginally as far as how far dilated I was. So we ended up having C-section. So before the C-section, or before labor and all of that stuff, I felt shitty. I felt terrible because of that abdominal tenderness that I was having. And I don't know if it's because of that or just because I recovered great or what, but I felt amazing after the surgery. Pretty much I felt better like once the baby came out, and then I felt even more better. I felt like way better after the placenta came out. So if you watched the our other video, you'll know that like the surgery was kind of traumatic for me. It's not for everybody, but for me, in my case, it was because of my tenderness. But afterwards, I felt wonderful. I can't even like emphasize how good I felt. At our hospital, they normally want the patients to get up 6 hours after surgery. I got up 4 hours after surgery, and I really could have gotten up sooner, but the nurse didn't want me to. She was like, no, you need to take it easy. But I really felt awesome that I could have gotten up after 3 hours. So that was really a blessing to feel so good. But it may have also been a downfall for me because I think afterwards, because I was moving around and moving and grooving so much, when I got home, or even the day that we were going home Sunday, like I started to feel kind of crummy. I was only taking, like, at our hospital they give you, you do have like narcotics and stuff available for you if you need them. But there's also like an anti-inflammatory drug that they can give you through your IV. It's called Toradol, and if your hospital offers that, you gotta take it. It's wonderful. It worked so good for me, and it's not narcotic, and it's totally safe for you and the baby. I really only used that up until probably Saturday evening. I started taking some Percocet because I felt, I started to kind of feel a little bit icky. But I was probably like in the middle of the night on Saturday. So Sunday morning. Anyways, so when we got home, I was feeling pretty good still. Of course, the car rides were horrible, the bumps. I was using an abdominal binder, and that made me feel like way better. So if you end up having a C-section, ask for a binder. It really does make a big difference. So I was wearing that, and that helped a lot. I was wearing that for at least like a week and a half, maybe even 2 weeks after surgery for me. It made me feel good. And then I had antibiotics for 24 hours. She had them for 48. We were going to need, we were testing her blood to see if she needed antibiotics for longer, but thankfully the blood cultures came back negative, so that's why we were able to go home. My incision. Part of my incision is kind of crooked on the left side. It's crooked, And so the edges did not like come together as pretty. And so I think that's the reason why I started to get an infection at home. It was really red, it hurt, it was tender. So I was communicating with my midwife and I was like, hey, I don't think it's that big of a deal, but you know, this is what's happening. And actually I started to like ooze. I was oozing pinkish stuff, like clear pinkish sort of. And I sent her a picture of what my incision looked like, and she said, put me on antibiotics. So I did antibiotics for 10 days, and everything after that was perfectly fine. So as of right now, a month after surgery, I am feeling awesome, pretty much. I feel good. I am at a 25 pound plus or minus weight loss, which has pretty much been the same since I think I lost that all within 2 weeks. So I haven't lost any since then. But I did have my postpartum appointment last week on Thursday when we were 4 weeks out, and everything looks great. My muscles are only one finger breadth separated, and she said that for a C-section, that's really awesome. Sometimes vaginal deliveries have it, you know, even worse than that. Postpartum, so I'm doing really good. She gave me the okay to start working out, so we are gonna start something. Like today I went walking, me and Naomi went walking, we did a mile walk, and also Jonas and I are doing like an abs and squat challenge. He's doing it with me. It's really not much of a challenge for him, I'm sure. And so hopefully I will continue to lose this baby weight. I gained like 45 pounds or more. So I need to lose that. Well, I want to lose that. Another thing, stretch marks. So y'all know I never got any stretch marks on my belly during pregnancy. I did get some stretch marks on my breasts like during pregnancy, but holy cow. Now, after like I've had the baby and all that, I've got stretch marks like galore, and it's really annoying. I expected to get more on my breast because when your milk comes in, they're just gonna get bigger, which they did. But I've got them like on my thighs and on my butt, and it's really annoying. I didn't get them at all during pregnancy. Why am I getting them now? But I did post that on Facebook, and a lot of mamas apparently had the same thing happen to them. So I guess it's not out of the ordinary, but it still sucks. And I'm really hoping that these stretch marks on my boobs fade so that I can feel sexy again. But that's what's going on. I think I hear Naomi starting to stir, so I'm going to go. Of course, the dogs are having fun not being supervised. So let me go handle that, and I will talk to y'all later. Bye. Deuces.